Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So today I'll be showing you how I achieved this classic red lipstick makeup look. Please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and enjoy. All the products I use will be listed in the description box down below. I start out by filling in my eyebrows using the average length brow pencil. I normally outline the edges and then fill in the inside. And then in the beginning of the brow, I draw hair-like strokes going upwards to avoid that harsh box brow look. And then I brush out just the beginning with the spoolie again, just to blend that out a bit so it doesn't look harsh. I now use the Rimmel London Brow This Way to set my brows. It's a gel, so it sets the hairs in place all day. Now I'm going in with my LA Girl Pro Concealer to carve out my brows. I mixed three shades in this pot because I initially bought a shade that was too dark for me, so I had to make it fit my skin tone. I not only covered my brows with the concealer, but I also put it on my lid so it can act as a good base for my eyeshadow. Now I'm going in with the L'Oreal Infallible Foundation. I mix two shades because that creates the perfect color for my skin tone. I blend it out with a damp sponge, and now I'm starting to highlight underneath my eyes with the concealer and my nose. I use the same damp sponge to blend out the concealer. You can dampen the sponge with tap water or your setting spray. I use my spring water setting spray to dampen the sponge. You want to make sure that your concealer is blended out well, especially around the edges. You don't want any harsh lines on your face. So now I'm just blending out the creases before I set them with the Yardley Translucent Powder. I like to set it to avoid creasing throughout the day. I also set my T-zone area because it gets a little oily. I set the sides of my nose and my smile lines to avoid creasing as well throughout the day with the same translucent powder. And then I use the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder to dust off the excess powder and set the rest of my face. Now I'm going in with the Revlon Colorstay Bronze to bronze my face. I normally bronze the perimeters on my face to avoid that mask look and to powder contour the hollows of my cheeks. I'm going in with my spring water setting spray. I don't have oily skin, my skin is dry, so I don't really need a mattifying setting spray. And I'm using the same bronzer to act as a transition color above my crease. I'm going in with this beige color to go directly in my crease. This will help us transition from brown to my lip color. I'm gonna go in with this gold color. I started out with the brush, but I found that I get more pigment when I use my fingers. just using the same brush I used to apply that beige color to just blend out the edges of the gold. And I'm going in again with the bronzer underneath my bottom waterline. I'm gonna go in with the design blush in the shade Fudge. I like it because it's subtle. To create my wing liner, I'm using the LA Girl gel liner and an angled brush. I'm going to be using the Design Kajal pencil to line my bottom waterline. And now I'm using the LA Girl lip liner in the color Chocolate to line my lips. I really like this color. I feel like it complements my lips really well. Now I'm using the Rimmel London lipstick in Diva Red. And for mascara, I'm using the Maybelline Colossal Cat Eyes Mascara. For highlights, I'll be using the Makeup Academy blush. It's very shimmery, so the highest points of my face, so above my cheekbones, my brow bone, and my nose. You're welcome to wear this look without lashes if you don't feel comfortable wearing lashes, but I think it also looks good with lashes. Don't forget to set your face with your setting spray, and we're finished.